time to go for some battles. Oh, I do look weak, don't I? Sorry, just a weak, I really am. Who's weak now? I think I might want to catch a spinner rack. Spinarak, the strange spit Pokemon. If prey becomes ensnared in its nest of spun string, it waits motionlessly until it becomes dark. Oh no! Should give him the berry. I didn't think there. Oh! I don't know why they just gave it to me. No, you're right there to the top. Come on, Pidgey, you can do it. Hurry, go ahead. What's Big Bear do again? Oh, self-cure for confusion. Nighty-night. Four Pokeballs. I gotta pray I don't get poisoned by these weirdos, because otherwise I'm gonna have to go to a Pokemon Center fast. So close. Let me get to one more battle to raise up my total so it is level 11. Water gun. Home of flying type Pokemon. Hey, I'm no trainer, but I can give some advice. Believe me, if you believe, a championship dream can come true. You believe? Then listen. The grass type is weak against the flying type. Keep this in mind. That's why I didn't choose Chikorita this time. Level 9. Critical hit. Already at the first gym. Pokeballs. Level 7. Oh, nice. Get ready to level up again. Come on, just one more scratch attack. And hopefully when I get to level 12, I can learn Water Gun. If I had an electric type, that would be a very easy match. But I'm always up for a challenge. Pidgeotto. Oh god, no more of those. It doesn't appear because I'm going, second. Is that all this bird knows? It's Gust? Sorry, Totodile. Oh! Yeah, I know my spinner works, I'm gonna get blown away. Yeah. Yeah, because bugs are weak to flying types. That's okay. If at first you don't succeed, you just try again. No, I really should have bought some potions and stuff, but wasn't thinking. Hope won't come back to bite me in the butt. Thank you. Ooh, that was a crit hit. That's alright. Come on, Pidgey, hang in there. And I beat my first gym leader with barely any health left. And Pidgey gets all those experience points. Learn Sand Attack, even though that's not really that helpful though. We got the Zephyr Badge too. Nice. And that was a very close match right there. I kind of wanted my Toadow to win, but it kind of makes sense that my Pidgey won instead. Against a fully evolved, well, not fully evolved, but an evolved form of itself. That must be Gust. Oh, Mud Slap, that's a ground type attack. Okay, I'll do that, but first I want to go back to the Pokemon Center and give my Pokemon some R&R. Course. I go to the Pokemart. And just in case, so I don't get poisoned by anything. And that was stuck there. I need the squirt bottle in order to get through there. Yeah, it's not really a tree, it's a pseudo world that looks like a tree.
Bellsprout! Bellsprout!
Well, first I want to get my toad down to level 13. And this should do it right here. Yep. Now I should be able to use a water gun. Nice. But I kind of want a grass Pokemon on my team there, and Bellsprout sure fits the bill. Not Hoo Hoo, though. Thank you.
Oh!
Yeah, Vine Whip is a good grass attack. It may not be that strong though, but strong enough to really do my Totodile some damage. Oh no. Okay, now it should be weak enough. If I lose my total down to this plant. And I know you probably are thinking, why didn't I choose Cyndaquil in the beginning? You're right. I just made a mistake though, but you know what? I'm gonna go with it still. Oh, come on! My last Pokeball for this damn Bellsprout. Almost lost my Totodile to this damn thing. Bellsprout, the flower Pokemon. If it notices anything that moves, it immediately flings its vine at the object. Then I go all the way back to the Pokemon Center, which is down over here. Yeah, so I can't go there right now until I get the squirt bottle. So I'm gonna pause the video, or wrap up the video right here. I take your guys, we'll do chapter 3 next time.